Hello, good evening students. Today morning we have derived the output equation for single phase transformer. It depends upon five parameters. Output equation of the transformer, it is Q. Q means KVA. KVA rating of transformer, Q equal to 2.22 F phi m AI AW, current density into 10^-3. You remember I told in the morning five fingers. You remember this is very useful to calculate the further formulas. Okay, sir. So today we have to derive the output equation for three phase core type transformer or three phase transformer. So it consists three limbs as shown in figure. It consists three limbs, two yokes, two window area. You observe the diagram very carefully. Once again, it consists three limbs, limb number one, limb number two, limb number three, vertical part of the core. And it consists two window areas, AW, two window areas. And on each core, that is limb part, consists one LV winding, one HV winding. It shows cross section, one LV winding, one HV winding. And center limb, again one LV winding, one HV winding. You observe. Then how much windings are available in one window? That means one LV winding, one HV winding on one side, another side again one LV winding, one HV winding. So totally we are having two LV windings, two HV windings in one window. This is only difference. In previous derivation for single phase, one LV winding, one HV winding, how we have taken, that already you are knowing. Now in three phase transformer, in one window it consists two LV windings and two HV windings. Very carefully while calculating the area of copper in window AC, that is only main difference. Except this, all steps are same. Okay, sir. No problem. Once again I repeating, first we have to write induced EMF equation, that is as usual 4.44 F phi m into T volts, where T is the turns, equation number one. Similarly, you can give the equation number two, volts per turn or EMF per turn, that should be equal to induced EMF divided by number of turns. Turns are going to cancel, 4.44 F phi m volts, that we have to get equation 2. What is the window space factor? Window space factor Kw is defined as area of copper in window, area of copper in window to total area of window. In symbol, Kw is window space factor. Kw is window space factor. AC is total copper area in window, AW window area. Hence, we may write Kw equal to AC by AW. Then you derive the equation 3. Therefore, area of copper AC may be written as AW into Kw. You give the equation number 3. Again, assuming the current density in primary and secondary winding same, current density, current per area, current density equal to current per area, IP by AP, IS by AS, amperes per. By knowing this equation, we may write cross sectional area of primary winding conductor AP. AP equal to IP primary current and primary winding current density is. That current density remains same. It is in millimeter square. Similarly, you may write cross-sectional area of secondary conductor. A is equal to respective current IS and respective current density. Again, it is in millimeter square. And one more assumption we are going to make. The primary winding turns must be equal to secondary winding turns with neglecting magnetizing MMF. So, ampere turns are expressed as AT, that is the product of current and number of turns. In general, AT, A is the current, T is the turns. But in actual, primary winding current is IP, primary winding turns are TP. So, it is the product of IP into TP. Similarly, secondary winding turns IS into TS. These all are equal. Generally is AT, AT equal to IPTP equal to ISTS. Very important here, it is only going to change here. Total coffer area in window. Total coffer area in window I have shown in early. I have shown in earlier diagram only one window area consists two LV windings and two HV windings. Hence, so two times I am multiplying, two times copper area of primary winding plus two times copper area of secondary winding. Then same story again continues. Copper area of primary winding should be equal to respective turns. How many turns are there? TP. Then what is the cross-sectional area of one conductor? That is AP. TP into AP multiplied by 2. This gives total copper area of primary winding. Similarly, secondary winding turns are TS. Secondary winding turns are TS. Respective cross-sectional area, that is AS. Then you are going to get 2 times of TS into AS, that gives total copper area of secondary winding. Then you write 2 times of TPAP, total primary, plus 2 times of TS into AS, secondary winding. So you replace the AP and AS in terms of current density. So AP equal to IP by current density, AS equal to IS by current density value. Then you come to the final of AC value. 2 is common and current density is common. 2 by current density equal to IPTP plus ISTS. It is already known that IPTP equal to AT in general ampere turns. Substitute that value AT plus AT. Hence, we are getting finally 4 times of AT divided by current density. That you can call equation number 4. Earlier, we are knowing from equation 3, AC equal to, already we are knowing general, KW equal to AC by AW. Therefore, AC equal to AW into KW, equation 3. Now, equation 4, AC equal to 4 times of AT divided by current density. Hence, you express, or I want to know AT, ampere turns must be equal to product of AW, KW, current density divided by 4. It gives equation number 5. This only difference between single phase and three phase. In single phase, AW, KW, current density divided by 2. Take into mind, remember. Hence, final KVA rating of transformer Q equal to, here we are having three phase calculations, VP phase voltage, IP phase current. Hence, 3 times of VP IP into 10 to the power of minus 3, convert into KVA. Hence, voltage per phase may be equal to induced EMF for phase Vp equal to Ep. Then you modify the equation 3 times of Ep Ip into 10 to the power of minus 3. Then I can rearrange the terms. Next equation, I can rearrange the terms Ep by Tp into Ip into Tp. Then Tp, Tp will going to cancel. Again, equation is not disturbed. But here, Ep by Tp is volts per turn, Et becomes. Ip into Tp, ampere turns becomes. Et 3 into At into 10 to the power of minus 3. Substituting these two values, Et and At in above equation, the Q becomes, you substitute all the values, it becomes equation number 5, 3.33 F pi m Aw Kw current density into 10 to the power of minus 3. Remember, again same 5 things, F pi m Aw Kw current density, same expression, but instead of 2.2, we are going to get 3.3. Remember, in case of three-phase transformer, it is 3.3. In case of single-phase transformer, it is 2.22. But instead of phi m, you want to replace phi m. Phi m equal to Vm into Ai. These all things depends upon given parameters in the problem. Okay, equation 5 and equation 6 both represents output equation of a three-phase transformer. Friends, you have to practice. I told in the morning, single phase, we went very detailed. After practicing, same you continue for practicing of three-phase. Design is the one of process. You recall the things. You have to write the general formulas. Then go for calculations. These two equations are to be remembered in module number 3. So, along with this equation, small derivation is there. Sometimes these both derivations are asked. Derive the output equation for single phase transformer and also obtain the relation between output equation and volts per turn. This also carries 3 to 4 marks. Totally you may get 10 marks. For this relation, you have to see there. Again, we have to start from very beginning. Consider the output equation of single phase transformer. Output equation of single phase transformer, or consider a single phase transformer, that's enough. So Q equal to again Vp into Ip, phase voltage, phase current into 10 to the power of minus 3. So already we are knowing Vp equal to Ep, induced EMF per phase. This is also voltage per phase. Hence, you substitute the value of Vp, 4.44 F pi m into Tp into 10 to the power of minus 3. You substitute the value 4.44 F pi m into Tp. It should be modified in terms of 4.44 F pi m Ip into Tp. You bring one side, Ip into Tp, that is nothing but primary side ampere turns. Develop the equation number 1. So it is well known fact phi m by At, in general phi m At is ampere turn, phi m by At is a constant. The ratio of phi m by At is a constant for a given transformer. Its value depends upon type of transformer, service availability and construction method of transformer. Hence, you take a constant value, let phi m by At equal to R, where R is a constant. Hence, you put in terms of ampere turns. Ampere turns may be written as phi m by R. Hence, you write the equation number 2. Substituting this At value in equation 1. You substitute just At equal to phi m by R. You substitute, what is the relation you are getting? 4.44 F phi m square R into 10 to the power of minus 3. hence from above equation phi m equal to this value under square root of r into 10 to the power of 3 divided by 4.44 f into under square root of q. You can call equation number 3. Then you go to the top, or we are knowing voltage per turn or EMF per turn, ET equal to 4.44 f times phi m. You substitute the phi m value from equation 3. From equation 3, you substitute the phi m value, then we are going to get ET equal to under square root of 4.44 f r into 10 to the power of 3 into under square root of q. So this all first square root you keep, or you may call another constant, that is k. ET equal to a constant k under square root of q. So this is the relation, final relation we want to derive. Q is kVA rating of transformer, k is a constant, ET is volts per turn. Up to this derivation carries nearly 4 marks, where k equal to, you write that value. It is already observed that phi m by at is a constant, depends upon type of transformer. K is another constant, its value also depends upon type, service condition and method of constructions. It may changes from transformer to transformer. Different transformers are having different K values. For example, this following table gives different K values: single phase cell type 1 to 1.2, single phase core type 0.75 to 0.85, and so on. If question comes, write the typical K values, means this table is essential. Again, it also carries 2 marks. Thank you, sirs. Please, you practice, all of you. Good night.